voice to text on any app using Microsoft's built-in speech recognition system. This would allow you to use voice on almost any app, things like Facebook, creating emails, replying to comments, even creating content for your blog. If this was your goal, this could save you hours. So the first thing you're going to need to do is go to your Windows settings. Just make sure your mic is enabled for voice dictation. If we go to Windows, this will only take a moment to check. So if you go Windows, Search, Sounds, and we're going to Sound Settings, the reasons to check, any device you plug in which has a microphone, for example, this webcam, if that gets plugged in, your system will then use this as the microphone. The only problem is if you've got other items that have microphones, say you've got a microphone like this or a headset, and you want that to be your microphone, if this is taking priority, you could be spending hours trying to work out why is this dictation not working for you. So if you just, as I say, go to Sound Settings, move that across, go to the top ones are your outputs. So these are your speakers, your headphones, your headsets. So that's all correct here. If we go to Input, and you'll see on here, I've got two devices. I've got my sound interface and the digital one, which is the camera capture card. I want this one, the analog in this case. So whatever your device is, it might show it by name. Just make sure that's the one that's selected. You'll see the bar there moving as I'm talking. You can see its activity. So it's picking up my microphone. I know I've just downloaded this. You don't need this. Separately, you can see as I'm speaking, that green bar is moving up and down, so I know my microphone's working, or hopefully it's working, otherwise this video is going to be really quiet. So now that's done, let's bring in a program that we can test it in. So I will bring Notepad. So I can either press the Windows key and H, or, because I use it on a regular basis, I've actually programmed these productivity keys. You can do all sorts on these keys to actually open, close software, to do anything you want. So I program this particular one. So when I press that key there, it triggers the device. So if I speak now, you will just see the words I say appear on screen. And it is that simple. If I want to turn off the dictation, I press that button there. If I'm not using the productivity keys, Windows key and H will turn it on. It will then start typing in whatever active window you've got. And to turn it off, I just press the escape key. So I'll turn off the sound for copyright purposes. So I'm on this channel. So if I wanted to leave a comment, all I've got to do is press or Windows key H. That brings up that. So I'm actually typing in this box as we speak. And it's as simple as that. And obviously, if I wanted to send it, I would just press. But I'm not going to do that because they'll wonder, what is this strange comment? But it's that simple. Escape to come out of it. I've got videos on how you can use the text-to-speech in all the other apps, things like Outlook, Word, and Google Docs. Each of them have got slightly different commands, so you can do advanced formatting, things like how to send it and all that kind of stuff. And I'll cover those separately in those three videos. So tap the subscribe button now so you don't miss them when they're released. This text-to-speech works in most apps I've tried. So I've opened up Google Docs. If I press Windows key H, I have got videos coming up on how to use it better in Docs. So Windows key and H can make your life really easier with speech recognition. Let us know in the comments how you will use these tools to your benefits, how much time do you hope to save. As you can see, I'm using this in Facebook. Let us know if this has been helpful by giving us a thumbs up or star rating. Don't forget, tap the subscribe button. That way you don't miss out on those videos which will show how you can use it in Word, Google Docs and Outlook. They have a whole set of different commands that will do all kinds of formatting and stuff like that. And I'll post those videos. So tap the subscribe button so you don't miss them. And I'll see you in this video.